I am truly a terrific loser. If I am faced with a situation that may cause mere morsels to quake, I don't. Fuck.
Week 9 would see the end of dapper entrepreneur Rafe Baggio.
The spoken word is my tool.
My name's Rafe, I'm CEO of Alpha Luxury Ice Creams.
Hi, Rafe. Nice
Hello.
To meet you. Hi.
My name's Rafe. I represent Renaissance Limited, a purveyor of fine fish.
Rafe is actually a very nice chap. He's a bit peculiar.
Let's absolutely kick ass.
He comes across in a kind of a funny way.
It wasn't as though I'd marked, you know, a shark hamster. I get on with prince or pauper.
Prince or pauper?
Correct.
And you're the prince?
No.
When it came to producing an ad campaign for a box of tissues, Rafe and co-star Michael were ready to roll.
I've done a lot of theatre in the past, not directing, but very much, you know, acting. This is the air, that is the glorious sun, this pearl she gave me. I do feel it and see it.
They were really enthusiastic about this task. They saw it as, a way of exercising their love and their desire of theatre and film and this, that. And they didn't see it as a business task. They completely lost it.
We're driving along, this is a motion shot, and you're scoffing away. Why are you going to do a task here, mate? So for heaven's sake, Georgie, half the yoghurt's still on your face.
All over your face. You stupid little shit.
I've always had this kind of secret megalomaniac type desire to control everyone on a set. So I thought directing was great fun.
You should become the next Fellini.
Yeah.
They completely went off into some different world, you know, forgetting that it's all about designing a box, selling the product. Imagine it's on a shelf in a supermarket. Imagine someone watching their advert. Will they go in and buy it?
When you wipe away the tears, that's when you smile.
Okay, well, let's do that again.
Let's do a take two. This is good. I'm doing well, mate. This is good. What we wanted very much is a non-Woody kind of, you know, DiCaprio-esque type way of acting. Apologies to DiCaprio. And I think we've got that on the bench scene, that, you know, there are no words spoken. Everything is done through gestures and action. So naturalistically, I think it's coming together.
But as their masterpiece took shape, Rafe and Michael lost sight of the product.
It never fails to amaze me, but Rafe and his team, or Fellini and Spielberg, as I called them, made a great film. But no one knew what they were selling.
For me, that bit's too quick. You don't see the brand at all.
I'm convinced that Rafe felt that when he walked into the boardroom that he was going to get an Oscar.
I don't know what your bloody advert's about. It doesn't mention the word tissues once in the voiceover, and it would not sell any tissues. It ain't gonna make me go and find and look those and look for those on the shelf. You're lost.
With their campaign in tatters, Rafe and Michael turned on each other.
Everything that is good about this advertisement, everything you like about it, came from me. No one else but me.
You're talking absolute gibberish. We both co-edited that. And if you're going to take the limelight for the success and like a rat, you know, jump off the sinking ship as soon as things hit
the fan, then you are seriously a flawed individual.
Because you're a man who always says, apparently, that you're honest. You're proven to be dishonest.
Hold on a second. I'm taking responsibility for that ad, but I had to make decisions for that ad.
As did I.
No.
Rafe was the project manager. His tendency towards artistry showed me that actually he doesn't know too much about business.
The one of you that's going is the one who actually I think is, with all due respect, a lot of hot air. Rafe, you're fired.
If it's a crime, then I'm guilty. Guilty of loving you.
leaving Michael, you know, it was as, you know, two friends would leave. You know, there was no acrimony at all. Shook hands and, you know, back to life. You know, business is business, and I'm happy, you know, I'm happy that people have to take those decisions, even though they're uncomfortable.
The following week, Rafe's ex-chum, Michael, would be next to go.
I'm a natural-born salesman. I'm pretty damn good. I'm not going to lie to you, I'm pretty damn good at it.
I'm basically a telesales recruitment and training manager, so selling is my crux.
I'm the best. I am the best. And it's not even taught. It's just there in me, in my blood. That is what I was born to do, was to sell.
Come on!
£50.
Michael's perception of himself is he said, you know, nothing in the world. You know, I can conquer anything. I'm a super salesman.
You can get the happy days. You got the job, mate.
I saw something in him, perhaps a bit similar to me as I was a youngster, and I kept giving him opportunities to actually show it to me.
There's a very limited amount of these, and they're only available today, and that is it.
In week 8, after failing to sell a single wedding cake, Michael had come within a whisker of getting the chop.
Michael, I think I've reached the end of the road with you. I'm sorry. Your attitude has been, yes, Sir Alan, I got that wrong. Yes, Sir Alan, I got this wrong. There is no room for any more mistakes, as far as I'm concerned. So,
Sir Alan, can I just say something, please? I don't want to sound like I'm begging, but if you can give me another opportunity to be a project manager, I won't let you down.
In week 10, Sir Alan did make Michael project manager, giving him the biggest sales opportunity of his life, selling supercar rentals to London's super rich.
As you can see, there are a fantastic array of some of the most prestigious cars in the world.
I need to make sure I win this task. I keep saying that, I keep losing, but this task I really need to win.
How do you think Michael is?
Shit.
I think he's shit as well.
The cars were a great bunch of cars. Who's going to hire those cars? High flyers, people with lots of money. Send your team to the places where people have got lots of money. Where'd he go? Portobello Road Market. He turns up outside some kind of Donna kebab shop and tries to sell £1,000 a day usage of a car. Total joke.
We are hiring out a Ferrari for you to drive for the day, £67 an hour.
Yeah?
That's all. Go on.
No, I'm not going to. I'm going to regret it. I can't do it.
He was completely useless. Totally and utterly useless. Had no idea and clueless.
£67, that's all it is.
I can't. I'm really sorry. I can't. It's too much.
Okay.
In the boardroom, Michael was wiped out. He lost by £9,000.
You tell me, what are you good at?
Sir Alan, I think that I'm a fantastic salesman.
But you didn't bloody sell, did you?
I think what I saw in the end was someone so full of themselves.
I think I've shown glimmers of brilliance since I've been here.
Don't get carried away with yourself, you know, don't get carried away. You know Bill Gates, trust me.
Actually, he can do sod all, really, when you look at it. When the end analysis over the course of the process, nothing. Disappointing. Slipped through the net, I have to say. You know, Sir Al doesn't get it right all the time, you know.
I think I've been fair in seeing the glimmer of light and letting you stay. You know, I've done that, to be honest, I think 3 or 4 times. Michael, I think this time